The holidays are a time for families to come together, but sometimes there are moments that can tear us apart, a hot-button topic or prickly personal questions. So, in today's Living a Better Life, here are four ways to deal with difficult family at the holidays. After the wine's been uncorked and the table's been set, sometimes the conversations that follow may prompt you to say, "Put a fork in it, I'm done."
So when you look at people who dread the holiday gatherings, is that something that is pretty common?
It's pretty common.
Dr. Stephen Huprick, a professor of psychology at the University of Detroit Mercy, says being caught off guard never makes anyone feel comfortable. So his number one way to deal with difficult family at the holidays is be prepared.
If you're anticipating the difficult question or the difficult topics or a difficult person, you sort of know, okay, this is what I'm stepping into, and now I can be more prepared and ready to deal with them.
Two, decide on the conversations you want to have. From politics to religion, it can get ugly fast. So think about how to bow out gracefully.
Particularly if there's somebody who is very opinionated or doesn't give up easily on trying to engage you and get into this discussion. I think knowing up front, here's what I want to say about it, here's all I'm going to say about it, and then kind of thinking, okay, if they come back with an alternative or they're trying to say more, what do you want to say back to that then?
Number three, remember your self-worth, especially if a family member starts being critical or judgmental about you or your life, asking personal questions about your marriage, your job, your fertility.
You've got your ideas, you're working on something, or you've made decisions not to do something that family members think you should do. Stay true to that.
Number four, pick your battles by deciding how you want your interactions to impact others.
You may win that battle if you really come back and tell them what you think, but maybe you lose the war. In other words, does it ruin the day, or do some people's opinion of you get diminished?
Dr. Huprick says sometimes you need to stand up for yourself. Just remember, privately off to the side of the tree won't leave the lasting impression of publicly flipping grandma's neatly set table.
Dr. Huprick says if relatives have been abusive to you in the past, you do not have to go to that gathering. Only you know what you're comfortable with. Bottom line, Dr. Huprick says some people simply lack self-awareness. They don't pick up on social cues when someone's feeling uncomfortable. So brainstorming some quick responses on how to handle those awkward questions can be part of that be prepared step. So I want to hear from you on Facebook. Let me know what some of your quick comebacks are to kind of nip that moment in the bud.
But yeah, but thinking about it in advance can help you deal with it, and just have that card ready to come out when they say something inappropriate. You're ready, then move away.
Exactly.
I'm sure you are so good at
that. Oh gosh. I'm usually like, what?
Yeah, right. No. That was great advice. Thank you.
I thought so, Dr. Huprick. Thank you very much for that.